Greetings, citizens of the world. This is an important message from Anonymous about how your governments are handling the growing coronavirus pandemic. Just over 100 years ago, in the midst of World War I, the world experienced a pandemic that killed tens of millions of people. Historians are divided on the exact number, but estimates range from 30 to 55 million people in about 2 years, which at the time, was around 1 or 2% of the world's entire population. 27% of the world's population was infected at some point during the outbreak. This great virus came to be known as the Spanish flu because that is where it was thought to have originated. However, it was later discovered that the first patients of this illness were soldiers from the French, British, and German armies who were fighting on the front lines of World War I. The governments of these countries went through great lengths to hide the outbreak so they would not reveal a strategical weakness to their enemies in the war. Spain, on the other hand, was a neutral territory in the war, so there was not as much of a motivation for that government to hide the outbreak, so Spain ended up being the first place where the cases were accurately reported. By the time that news of the situation in Spain reached around the world, it was too late, the virus had spread just as fast as the news. Sadly, as the pandemic grew out of control, governments around the world, including the United States, did their best to limit reporting on the illness to prevent panic or social unrest, and to help maintain troop morale. Many experts have compared the recent COVID-19 novel coronavirus to the Spanish flu. Bill Gates has said that we could be dealing with a once-in-a-century pandemic which could be as deadly as the virus that wiped out tens of millions of people exactly a century ago. These two illnesses are not from the same family of pathogens, but there are some important similarities between these two outbreaks, and we may be making some of the same mistakes as those who came before us. In China, doctors, activists, and everyday citizens have been threatened with arrest for posting information about the virus that creates any alarm or contradicts official statements.
Well, a man who's become incredibly well known around the world because of the coronavirus has died. This is the Chinese doctor who tried to warn the medical community about the coronavirus. He was told to be quiet by the authorities before weeks later being diagnosed with the virus himself.
Before passing away from the coronavirus himself, whistleblower Dr. Li Wenliang said that the Chinese government knew that human-to-human transmission was taking place weeks before they told the public what was happening. Christian Anderson, an evolutionary biologist at the Scripps Research Institute, has estimated that the virus could have infected its first victim as far back as October 1st, based on a study of 27 genomes from early patients. This means that the virus was spreading all over Wuhan, and the world, for the past few months. If this research is correct, that means that this virus had likely made its way to every corner of the world by the time the Chinese government decided to shut down Wuhan. This may sound like an exaggeration because we are just now finally starting to see some confirmed cases in the United States and Europe, but let's take a minute to examine what a confirmed case actually is. A confirmed case is a person who has tested positive for the virus, but the number of test kits is limited and the CDC has refused to authorize test kits for many of the suspected cases because they are keeping such strict criteria for who the tests get sent to. Making matters even worse is the fact that some of the tests have been shown to be faulty, and officials admitted that one of the facilities that was tasked with analyzing the tests was contaminated. Testing has begun to accelerate in the United States and Europe, now that deaths have been reported, and health experts are beginning to find clusters of the virus with no clear link to the epicenter, meaning that community spread has already begun. In Seattle, which is looking like one of the first epicenters in the US, experts believe that the virus has been spreading silently amongst the population for at least 6 weeks. This type of silent spread is possible due to the massive incubation period of the virus. Some studies have suggested that the time of incubation for this new virus could be up to 24 or even 27 days, meaning that an infected patient could be walking around for a month infecting other people without even knowing that they are sick, which greatly increases the pathogen's ability to spread undetected. Compare this with the incubation period for the flu, which is 1 to 4 days. Speaking of the flu, the coronavirus outbreak may have gone undetected for these first few months because it was being mistaken for an especially bad influenza season. In Washington, where we now know there has been an active coronavirus outbreak for months, the State Department of Health recently published some interesting statistics about hospital visits for flu-like symptoms. The charts below show how this year there has been an unusual number of people who experienced flu-like symptoms but did not test positive for the flu. Figure 9 shows the percentage of people who tested positive for influenza, while figure 10 shows the percentage of influenza-like illness, ILI, cases where there was a negative result on the flu test. Figure 9 shows a relatively normal flu season, if not a relatively mild one, but figure 10 shows cases of a mysterious flu-like illness above the epidemic threshold. As this is unfolding, the governments in China, Iran, and Italy, some of the areas worst hit by the outbreak, are telling their citizens that the situation is under control and that the virus isn't something that they should worry about. In Iran, people are becoming less confident with these claims, as multiple members of the government have now become sick with the illness. In Italy, at least one governor, Attilio Fontana, was quarantined after coming into contact with an infected staff member, and the Pope has cancelled all of his appearances for nearly a week after falling ill with a sickness that the Vatican refuses to disclose. The governments of Japan and South Korea appear to be somewhat more honest with their citizens in this matter, and seem to be testing more thoroughly. United States President Donald Trump has claimed that the country is in great shape for the coming pandemic, but has provided American citizens with very little of substance during his recent press conferences on the subject, aside from assurances that everything is going to be just fine. The Trump administration is attempting to control the flow of information about the virus to keep people optimistic, just as the governments of China and Iran are doing, but this approach is putting people in grave danger, just as the administrations of the previous century had during the Spanish flu. In order to understand the seriousness of the situation, people need to know about the high rates of mortality and hospitalization for this illness. Furthermore, to adequately protect themselves, people need to know that this illness has a significantly longer incubation period and is much easier to catch than the seasonal flu. These are now established findings that should be at the front of every news bulletin and press conference, but they are being left to the footnotes or entirely ignored. Adequate testing and reporting should have started months ago, and sadly, the powerful people who have appointed themselves as our leaders are actually holding us back, instead of leading. Do the right thing and tell the people of the world what we're actually dealing with. We are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.